Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This week we're going to be painting this barn owl. This is the second one in the series of about four. Let's go through our colors. We'll have titanium white, black, raw umber, burnt umber, raw sienna, yellow ochre, ultramarine blue, and a light pink. We're only going to need four brushes, so we'll have like a medium or large, flat or filbert, a small flat or filbert, one that's a little bit smaller than that. It's a flat or filbert, and then a liner brush. Those are the only four brushes that you'll need. You can use a fan brush in one of the stages, but that's optional. You don't have to have it. I'll show you how to make the brush strokes. So those are our four brushes, and let's get started. So we're going to start by putting in our background, and for this, I want to get some ultramarine blue, some raw umber, a little bit of yellow ochre, maybe a little bit more ultramarine blue. And this background is going to be pretty dark, but that's what we want. And so we're just going to start up here and put this in with the largest of our flat brushes, this size. And it's like a dark brown. It might have like a little bit of a green tint to it. You can put in more than one coat of this. I would wait to the end if you're going to put a second coat. So we're just scrubbing this in here. If you have some variation in color, that's okay. I'm just going to mix some more of that. There's a lot of background in this painting, so we'll use a lot more than the other painting that we did. And I'm not worrying too much about, as I'm mixing this color, making it exactly match or anything like that. I kind of like the variations in color in the background instead of it just being one solid color. If your brush gets a little dry, you can dip it in water. It looks a little bit more green this time. But I'm okay with it. It gives it a little bit of interest. I just want to get all of this white covered up. Okay. That looks good. And like I said, at the end of this painting, if you want to go back over the background again, just do a little bit more of that mixture and go back over it. It should be fine because it'll be dry by then. And you can rinse your brush out. Scrub all of that dark color out of there. And then dry it off on your towel, making sure you get all that color out of there. Now we're going to work on this little stump down here. We will get some raw umber. And wherever you see these little lines at, just put in raw umber. Your lines can be thinner than this if you want. I'm just not being too precious about it. Okay. And we're going to add a little bit of white to the raw umber to gray it up a little bit. A little bit more white. Just going in between those darker lines that we did. Don't worry, we're leaving some of it white. white to that mixture. We're going to put in a couple little spots of that white. So now it's like a really light gray. I'm going to add in some more raw umber. Make it a little bit darker. I just want some variation. I don't want it to be all one color. So I'm just playing with the grays a little bit. Okay, and you can rinse your brush out. Okay, we're still going to be working with this gray. I'm going to add a little bit of white. If you still have some of that mixture of the raw umber and white, I just added a little bit more white to it. And I think I'll put a smidge of the raw sienna in with it to orange, make it a little bit orange. And I'm going to put this in here. I think I want it a little bit lighter. So I'm just doing quick little strokes, just playing with it. Very light pressure. Just follow with what I'm doing. Okay. A little here. Very light pressure, guys. Okay, and now we're going to add even more white to that mixture and lighten it up a lot. And we're going to fill in these areas. Just follow along with what I'm doing. Okay. And you can rinse your brush out. Make sure it's dry. You don't want it to be too wet. And we're going to fill in some of this dark area. We're going to get some raw umber and a little bit of ultramarine blue. And we're going to go in between here. And here. Okay. We're just gonna bring this color around here too. Just really lightly. The harder you press, the thicker your line will be. So if you press light, your line or your stroke will be thinner. Okay, you can rinse your brush out. We're going to go back into our gray again, and we're going to add even more white to it. We want a really light gray. It's going to look almost white. We're going to go around here. And here. And here. We're also going to go around here. Very lightly. Okay, we're going to put this light color here. It almost looks white, but it's not. It's still a little gray. And rinse your brush out. And dry it off. We're going to go back into that. If you have any more of that ultramarine and raw umber mixture, I forgot a little spot down at the bottom. here that we need to fill in. And that's going to go here. And here. Okay. And I kind of lost this line, so I'm going to put that back in. Just really lightly. Okay, and you can rinse your brush out. Oh, I forgot another part. So get the ultramarine blue and the raw umber again, and just put in that little line there. Okay. Now let's see. We're going to go into our raw sienna. And we're going to put that in over here. And down here. Down here. Down here. And down here. I see a little bit of that color over here as well. Not a lot, just a little bit. You can rinse your brush out. Okay, so we are going to go back into our raw umber and ultramarine blue. Make sure it's going to be more blue than raw umber. We're going to fill in this area here. Just follow along with what I'm doing. We're also going to fill in this little area here under his little feet. cause. I'm gonna add a little bit of more raw umber to darken it up. I'm going to put these lines back in. I'm just going to add some more of this color down here since we have it out. I'm not covering up everything that we did. I just want to add in a little darker color. And I'm just dragging my brush down in some areas to make it a little bit darker. Okay. And you can rinse your brush out. This is just my little towel that I dry my brush off on after I rinse it off. Okay, so let's get our smaller round or liner brush, and we're going to go into our black and we're going to get his eyes in. And go over to the other side and get the other eye in. Okay. We're going to go into our burnt umber. And we're going to mix a little bit of raw sienna with that. So that's burnt umber, raw sienna. Maybe a little bit of white to lighten it up a little bit. And this is going to be the color that's going to go around the eyes. Just outline the eyes with that. To the other eye. Around the eye with that. Okay. And rinse your brush out. And we're just going to do the burnt umber this time. And add in a little bit of that color here and here. Rinse your brush out. I know we're skipping all over the place, but next we're going to get some burnt umber and a little bit of that pink color and a little bit of white. Maybe a little bit more of the light pink. rinse your brush out. You're going to get some of the light pink again and white. So it'll be a really, really light pink. And we'll put in his little beak. It almost looks white, but you can still see a little bit of the pink. We'll put a little bit of that here and here. Okay. Rinse your brush out. We're going to go back into our raw umber and white. Make it gray. And we're going to go around here. And here. And then around here. And down here. Up here. And we're going to go around here. And then we're going to do it down the middle here. And around here. Put a little bit here. A little bit here. And now we're going to add a lot more white to where it's almost all white to the raw umber. And we'll fill in the rest of this. And we're using our small round. And we'll go around here. Some of this down here too. Okay, now we're going to go into our, you don't have to rinse off your brush, we're just going to go into our raw sienna. And put it in around here. Okay. And we're gonna, if you have any of that ultramarine blue and raw umber mixture, I want it to be more ultramarine blue. So it's more blue than brown. Gonna go right around here. See, it looks really dark, but it's really like a dark bluish color. We're going to go around here. Okay. And we're gonna dot in some of that color up here. And dot in some of that color around here. I'm just like haphazardly dotting it in. Okay, and you can rinse your brush out. Let's move back over to this wing. And we're still using our small round or liner brush, and we're gonna go into our raw umber and mix a little bit of burnt umber with it. And we're gonna put in these little wings, feathers. There's lines on the pre-sketch drawing for this. Just follow those lines. And rinse your brush out. We're going to go into our yellow ochre. And right in between those lines that we just did, we're going to tap in this yellow ochre. And here. Here. Okay, I'm going to put a little bit of that color down here too. And that's just yellow ochre. There's no mixture to it. Okay, rinse your brush out. Okay, so we have to tackle these, I guess, feet, hooves, no. What do you call them? I don't know what you call them. But we're going to go into our light pink and white. We're going to fill in talons, maybe. Okay, and you can rinse your brush out. You're gonna put in, okay, so I know that these are called talons, little claws or whatever. There's one over here. And one right here. One right here, and this is just black. And one right here. I have a little bit too much water on my brush. have one over here. Okay. We're going to let that dry. We're not going to mess with that too much. And now my brush is pretty dry. I just have a little bit of black left on it, and I'm just scrubbing that in there. Okay. Get a little bit of raw umber and white. And we're going to line the top of this tree stump with that color. Okay, and then we're going to add a little bit of that color onto the, well, we're going to add a little bit more white. And add a little bit of color to these talons. We're not going to cover the black completely. We're just adding a little bit of highlight to it with the white. Okay. And rinse your brush out. We're going to get our small flat or filbert. And we're just getting straight white now. And we're gonna go around this wing. Just straight white, no mixture. And we're just gonna tap that in. All the way down. Gonna put it in here, and I have my brush kind of turned sideways, and I'm doing little quick strokes with this white. And this is just white. Very little water on my brush, if any. And I'm doing these quick little strokes like this. Just follow along with what I'm doing. I'm kind of, I hope you can see how I'm making these strokes. I have my brush turned sideways, and I'm just pressing and lifting to make these strokes. Just pressing and lifting. Okay. And again, I'm just dabbing this white in here. I'm not covering up all of the gray that we did. But when you're working with like white feathers or white hair or white fur, you have to have something to contrast it against. So that's why we add in all of the variations of gray. That way when we put in the white, it can really pop. Okay. And I'm still just using the straight white. I'm going around here, just tapping this color in. And even though I have a reference photo, I'm just using it as reference. I'm not trying to copy it completely. It's just a reference so I can get an idea of what I want. I'm just lightly brushing some of this white down here. And up here. Okay. You see how I'm going over the gray, that darker gray that we had, but I'm just lightly going over it with the white. Like I'm not taking away the gray completely. I'm just lightly going over it with the white so that you can still see the gray and you can still see the variation of color and highlights and shadow. And it makes the white pop. Okay. You can rinse your brush out. And we're going to get our liner brush again, or our small round, and we're going to go into the burnt umber, and I kind of want to line this beak on this side and across the top. Adding a little bit of that color here as well. And I want to get a little bit of white and add some in the beak. Add a little bit over here. And I want to just put two little a little dot in each eye. And line each eye. Okay. Gonna get some black and clean this up a little bit under here. Rinse your brush out. I want to add a couple little final highlights to these talons again with just white. And then maybe some down here. Just in random areas, add some lighter color. And this is just straight white. And if you want to go back and work on the background some more, add a second layer to the background. That was ultramarine blue, raw umber. And this time, let's put a lot of yellow ochre. It's going to really lighten it up, and we can add some contrast to this background. And we're just scrubbing it in random places. We're not covering the whole thing. And we'll do the same thing over here. We're just scrubbing it in. Now I'll add a little bit of white to that mixture and put that in some places too. If you don't like the way this is coming out, you can skip this part. You don't have to do this part. And then I'll put a little bit of that color over here. I love the green that makes. And that is about it for this painting. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on my notifications for my next tutorials. If you have any questions, leave them down below. Any comments, leave them down below. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.